Hello, snowboarders of the internet. I'm your host, Averyn Lefebvre, and in this video, we'll be reviewing the 2021 Marhar Invasion snowboard. This board features Marhar's reverse camber, which is actually a flat to rocker. So you have a flat section, and then it goes into rocker in the tip and the tail. It's going to make this board a little more loose and playful and forgiving. This board is available in 151, 154, 154 wide, 158, and 158 wide. I rode this board at Copper Mountain on a sunny bluebird day that had zero winds, where the snow was firm and fast and then slowly just changed into slushy and lumpy, and I rode it with my Rome Black Label bindings and my K2 Thraxxus boots. For 2021, they tweaked the core on this board and made it a little bit softer. Now it comes in at just a little bit below middle of the road. So you've got softer tip and tail, right? So they really just soften that up. And then they made it way softer between the feet, so you can really just torsionally twist this board a lot more. Basically, it's soft and playful. Now, with that being said, you are going to feel some chatter. It is going to resonate back underfoot. This board is not the dampest, and it's a lot more lively. So just be prepared to feel that, especially if you get into rutted out terrain, you're really trying to push through it. This board will get knocked around a little bit. With the camber profile on this board, it has a very skate-like effect to how it actually pops. So you don't really load it up, you just sort of ride along and then boom, snap, and there you go. Is it the snappiest thing out there? No. Will it get the job done? Yes. You can basically turn rollers into launch ramps, side hits into booters, and when it comes to jumps, small to medium is really where this board shines. If you're going to take it to bigger ones, you got to have the skills to know how to set it down. It's just a little looser in the tips than I think you would really want hitting a bigger jump, but like small, medium sized stuff, probably going to be totally fine. What's nice about this board is it's playful and predictable. You know what you're going to get with it. The sweet spot in the nose and the tail is immense, and it locks in when you butter. You really just feel your weight being out on there and holding it. The board never fights you. It's one of those boards that you can just manipulate it however you want, and then when you need to snap out of it, it's there if you want it, but you're not going to have to worry about having to man through it or overpower it to get what you want. It just snaps as you would want it. Now with that said, when it comes to jibbing, this thing locks into presses. You can just hold a tail press, hold a nose press. It's there, it's solid, it's stable. Now when you get sideways on a feature with that softer torsional flex, it really locks in, it holds, it slides exceptionally well. You don't really have to worry about it hooking up or anything like that. Basically, this board is great at jibbing and buttering, but then again, this is what it's designed for, so I'd hope it would be good at that. Can you carve on this board? Yes. Would I aggressively carve on this board? No, there's limitations with it. Short, tight, quick setup turns, yeah, fine. It rolls easily enough from edge to edge. You're gonna notice that it's nimble where it needs to be. But when you go to drive a hard, deep, aggressive carve and you're really pushing off the tail, 9 out of 10 times, it folds and washes up. There's severe limitations. You have to know how to engage this board and when to really push the button to drive it hard. You're gonna find that most times, you're gonna be holding back with how hard you wanna aggressively carve with it. It's one of those boards that swooping carves, yeah. Tight, quick setup turns, sure, but deep, hard, aggressive carves, eh, you might wanna just skip it on that one. So who's this board for? The park-focused rider that wants something that's a little more soft and playful. Comparable boards, the K2 Worldwide Weapon, the Battalion Global Warmer, the Capita Horrorscope. So personally, I think that they may have softened this up a little too much for 2021. It's just a little more playful than what it actually should be. So if you're riding like a smaller hill, East Coast, Rope Toe, stuff like that, you'll probably be fine. But if you're going to anything bigger where you might need to push it, it's gonna lack a little bit. It's gonna be a little looser. It's not gonna be as precise. It's going to be very forgiving for sure, which isn't a bad thing. I mean, if you're a jib guy that wants something playful, yeah, definitely this is good for you. But if you're someone that wants a little bit more precision, just a little more snap and rebound, a little more stability, a little more dampness, it's going to be lacking a little bit. This has been my review of the Marhar Invasion. Do you agree? Do you disagree? Do you own one? Are you going to buy one? Leave me a comment down below. Let's have a conversation about this snowboard. If you're new here, remember to subscribe, click the bell, get those notifications. That way you're not missing any of the videos we got coming out for all you snowboarders of the internet. And If you really want to support us and just see us grow out what we're doing here, swing on over to Angry Snowboarder VIP. I could tell you more here, but I got a video over there that explains it so much better. As always, I've been your host, Averyn Lefebvre, and I'll see you in another video.